Hi, I'm Chase Sharkey with Sharkey Mechanical. Our team of experts handle some of the largest and most complex air conditioning systems in the state. Give us a call today and let us attack your air conditioning needs. 225-222-3332.
What a great occasion it was here at the Parish Council in A meet when What a great occasion it was here at the Parish Council in A meet when Tangipahoa's library was honored, recognizing 75 years of service. On hand, Barry Bradford, a bit of an amateur historian himself. Boy, what an occasion, 75 years.
Yes, it's really exciting to think that this library has been serving this community for 75 years and has been doing it in a consistent basis. And also, some of the things that they started doing 75 years ago, we still do. Basic mission is still the same. We still provide information for the community and provide it to everyone, regardless of background.
Well, think about Tangipahoa's library system. It's large, lots of branches, relative to just 135,000 people.
Yes, it is. We have six locations, and we do serve 135,000, about 135,000 people, which is comparable to Livingston Parish. And we're very proud of the fact that we're able to accomplish this on a relatively small budget. We don't have the largest budget in this part of Louisiana, but I think we do a really great job of supporting the needs of our community with that money.
Well, good plug for the fact that you actually have half the millage that Livingston gets for their library.
Just about half, that's right. We have 5.81 mills. I think Livingston has 10. They do a great job, and I think we do too, and I'm very proud of our staff.
So, recognizing this occasion, what can you share with us about the history of the library system here?
Well, I would say that while the mission has stayed the same, a lot of things have changed. And in fact, a lot of the change that we've seen in our library has happened within the last 30 years. Beginning in the 90s, we moved to automation. We began to offer internet access. We began to have different types of media available. Besides records, we had cassettes, but also we're moving into the digital age with CDs and DVDs. And of course, now we're moving on from that to streaming video, streaming movies, streaming TV shows, a lot of stuff coming through our website, tangilibrary.com.
One thing I remember, you know, during this era of Black Lives Matter, it wasn't that many years ago that the system actually had some libraries primarily for blacks and some primarily for whites. For example, I remember that for years, there were two libraries in Kentwood, and that was the justification. One was mainly for the African American community. Hard to believe that that could be in modern times.
That's true. There was a separate library assigned for African Americans in Kentwood. That's true. I believe that changed about 50 so years ago. And of course, we provide service to all of our citizens, regardless of their ethnic background or religious background. We provide materials for everyone.
But I mean, it goes to show you that times change.
They do change. They change quite a bit. And I think overall, we've changed for the better. I think we're in a good place right now. Of course, saying that, obviously we're dealing with the coronavirus pandemic, but you know, we're still able to provide quite a bit of material, especially online. So you know, the coronavirus has hit us, but people are still accessing our materials 24 hours a day.
Matter of fact, on that subject, do you find that there are more people than ever who are digitally accessing what the library has to offer?
No question about it. We've seen a rise in electronic card applications. We've seen a dramatic rise in the use of our Wi-Fi. We've seen a lot of people using much more our ebooks, our downloadable audiobooks, our movies and TV. So yes, we've seen a dramatic increase in that.
It occurs to me that there'll be a certain population of students in the upcoming school year who will be going to school at least part of the time, and in some instances all the time, just by computer. Such students will probably utilize the library online a lot more.
I sure hope so. We have always sort of built ourselves as an auxiliary, perhaps that's the wrong word. We're there to help the school system. We're there to provide support for our students in our school system. Homeschooling, as well as private schools, public schools, we want to provide the materials that these young people need. We buy books that are in the curriculum quite often. And one of the things we offer that I think is great is World Book online. You can get World Book anytime, day or night, through our website. And that's something that I think all students, pretty much all ages, can use. So yes, as they go into this new phase of education, we will be there as much as possible to provide those electronic materials, yeah.
Well, one thing we parents have had to do is to tell our kids that there's a lot more to research than just Googling something and a lot more than just Wikipedia.
You know, when I was in high school, I went to the library and pulled out Reader's Guide and pulled out magazine articles. I did it all, you know, by hand, as you did, I'm sure. And that's changed quite a lot. Now, I think a lot of times we go to Google first. I mean, sometimes I do that. We look at Wikipedia. But, you know, the library has vetted materials, too. Materials that have been written by scholars, people that have the background. You know, Wikipedia is great, but it's not necessarily by people who are trained in a particular field. Google is great, but you don't always find things that are necessarily vetted or supported by scholarship.
Well, where I live in LaRonda, I know the library is used as a hub. In other words, people can go there and just be in the parking lot and utilize high-speed internet. Maybe they don't have that at home. The same is true, I know, in Kentwood, because you make sure that your libraries have high-speed internet even if the neighborhood they're in does not.
That's correct. And, you know, we do have people all hours of the day and night using our Wi-Fi. We're very proud of the fact that we have it available 24/7. We're also about to roll out something new. We are about to roll out hotspots, mobile hotspots that people can check out. And we particularly want to target LaRonda and Kentwood because those areas have very poor internet access. And one of the things we want to do is try and get that access out to the people in those communities. So we will be doing that in the next few months. We'll be making those available for checkout.
What else do you want to share with us?
Well, even though we don't have the programs, face-to-face programs going on right now, we do have virtual programs through our Facebook page. We are doing a lot to try to keep our branches open, to keep them safe, sanitizing them, making sure our staff are well supplied with masks and gloves and so forth for them and for the public. So when you come into our library, we can say we've done everything we can to keep you safe and your family safe.